Hi and welcome to the 11th video in the series of Bet Genes, and today we're going to be looking at translation. So at the end of last time we looked at, or you finished off looking at, transcription. And so the end product of transcription is this single-stranded piece of genetic material called mRNA, or messenger RNA, and that's represented here by this red line. Now the mRNA is able to move from the nucleus out into the cytoplasm. And the reason why it needs to move to the cytoplasm is it needs to move to this organelle called a ribosome. And a ribosome is actually the organelle that builds the protein. So as the mRNA moves out of the nucleus, it moves towards the ribosome, and the ribosome is represented by this blue structure here. You can see that the mRNA has its traditional triplet code. So the triplet code means the set of nucleotide bases found in threes, and so each triplet code will code for a specific amino acid. And if you remember back, these amino acids, there are 20 of those, and so amino acids go together to form proteins. So this piece of mRNA here, it consists of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 triplet codes. Now in reality, a piece of mRNA will consist of, or can consist of, several thousand triplet codes. So at either end of the mRNA code, there's a start codon and a stop codon, and the start codon tells the ribosome where to start reading from, and the stop codon indicates where it needs to stop. It's also the end of the code for the protein. Now there's this other molecule that we have up here called transfer RNA. Now what that's going to do is that has a very specific code, or this transfer RNA has a very specific code, in this case UAC. And because the nucleotide bases bind up in very, very specific ways, so with this instance U will bind with A will bind with U, and C will bind with G, and hence why the shape of these bases will fit the shape of these bases, and hence they'll fit together. And this triplet code is known as the anticodon. This triplet base here is known as the codon, and so they will bind. So this transfer RNA has an anticodon of UAC. So a transfer RNA that has UAC will always code for the same type of amino acid, one of the 20 that it could possibly code for. And then the next thing that will happen is another transfer RNA molecule. However, this time this has got a GGG anticodon, and because G binds with C, it's a complementary shape to this codon, it will then come in here and bind. Now you probably realised from before that a protein is several amino acids joined together. So in order for this to become a protein, the two amino acids need to join up, and so this is what happens. So this bond that happens between amino acids forms between these two and is referred to as a peptide bond. Now the next thing that would happen was this transfer RNA here is now free to move away. It's done its job, it's brought the correct amino acid in, it's now free to move away, leaving behind the other amino acid, and that can then go off to pick up this specific type of amino acid here, AA1. You then get the ribosome moving along, and so it's going along to read the code. And so now it's looking for a transfer RNA that has an anticodon of CCC, hence this one in here. Because they have a complementary shape with the codon, it comes in and it binds. Again, the same thing happens. Amino acid 2 and amino acid 3 need to join up, and therefore you get a peptide bond being formed between those two. And this continues all the way down to the bottom end of the mRNA until it reaches the stop codon. And so what you're left with is the complete protein, this one consisting of 8 amino acids, and it's then free to go off and do whatever function that is, whether it whether that's an enzyme used to catalyze a reaction, or whether that's used to form some form of tissue. Okay, so in summary, the first thing that happens in translation is that the mRNA leaves the nucleus and moves towards the ribosome in the cytoplasm. The ribosome then enables transfer RNA, or specific transfer RNA, to bind to the mRNA, and it binds to the triplet code, and the transfer RNA also has something that's referred to as an anticodon, which is a triplet code. And that transfer RNA, along with its anticodon, brings with it a specific amino acid. The ribosome continues to move down the mRNA, bringing in the correct transfer RNA and therefore the correct amino acid. Those amino acids join up via a peptide bond, and this continues to happen until the ribosome reaches a section of the mRNA that codes for a stop, and hence the protein is made, and then it can be used